Hi folks, this is Don, and I thought I might take a few minutes to answer a question that one of you posted in the preparation for the midterm exam. And it has to do with constructing confidence interval for the population mean mu. You're given the confidence level of 0.95, the sample mean x bar 5.7, the population standard deviation sigma of 0.8, and an N of 41. Now, Ernesto went through and worked the problem, and he did it using the formulas that are given in Larson and other textbooks, in which you go ahead and find your critical value of Z, you convert your sigma to the S, the standard deviation of the sample, by dividing of the square root of 40 of N, which is 41, and you crunch those numbers down and you end up with a margin of error, or really an interval width, to be more precise, that you add and subtract to the sample mean. Now, Ernesto says round it to 0.2, and depending upon what my stat lab asks or what your problem is, that's okay. Generally, what I like to do is keep it out to 3 or 4 decimal places until the very end, and then round. And I did notice a little minor thing here. In his explanation, he shows the x minus the interval less than x plus the interval, which is correct. And then he shows that same thing with the numbers inserted, which is correct. But on the final step, he reverses it. Generally, you would have the lower limit, then the mean, then the upper limit. But the values are okay. But let's do it using first StatCrunch. I'm going to bring up StatCrunch. And you can, if you're interested, find the critical values of Z using the normal calculator in StatCrunch. Because we've got a confidence interval, that means we've got critical values both on the lower and the upper, and we have to divide the alpha by 2. So that would be 0.025, I think. Click compute, and we get a negative 1.96 for the lower end, and by symmetry we know that on the upper end we have a positive 1.96 for our two critical values. So that's useful. When we get ready to actually calculate the confidence interval, one thing I wanted to point out, if you remember, whenever we're doing a hypothesis test and then the confidence intervals around those, you have to make a decision whether to use a z-test or t-test. And there are two things that you need to look for. If you're given the population standard deviation sigma, then generally you use the z-test. And that is what we have in this case. If you're not given the population standard deviation, if you're given the sample standard deviation, then generally you have to use the t-test. But here we have this population standard deviation. And here's where I see a lot of students getting confused. We have our sample mean, and let me pull this down again so we can see that, of x bar 5.7, our standard deviation. Now here it gets confusing. Notice it doesn't say sample standard deviation. It says standard deviation, which implies sigma. So we just put 0.8 in there. We don't have to convert it to S. Our sample size is 41. We go down here and we click on confidence interval for our level. Make sure that's equal to our level of 0.95. And we click on compute. And we get our answer. We get a lower limit of 5.455 or 5.46 and an upper limit of 5.94. Let's see if that's what... Yeah, that's what Ernesto got. He rounded it to 5.5, which if you round that all the way up, you'll get 5.5 and round that. Oh, that'll be close because if you round 48 to be 0.5 and then 5 to 0.95. So that would be close to 6.0. Depends on how you go about doing your rounding. So that's how you do it using StatCrunch. It's really pretty straightforward. And the only tricky thing is to remember when you're looking at this dialog box that is the population standard deviation, not the sample standard deviation. So you don't want to divide by the square root of n. Okay. Let me show you another way of doing this. And this is using a add-in that you can get called PHStat. It's an Excel add-in. Those of you who are going to go on and do Business 430, you will need to get the PHStat add-in. Generally, if you have a Pearson account, and I think it works even if you have a MyStatLab account, you can navigate over to the Pearson site and download either a free copy of PHStat, or you, for $10, can buy a copy. And it's a bargain. You're buying a copy, you're not buying a license, so once you get it, you can continue to use it from then on. And it's a good tool. This is the output, but let me show you how it works. Click on PHStat, and we've got confidence intervals. And here we have a choice. We've got estimate for the mean sigma known, which we do know sigma, or you've got estimate for the mean sigma unknown. And what that does is does the calculation that Ernesto showed you. But let's just click on sigma known. We bring up this dialog box. Our population standard deviation is 0.8. Our confidence level is 95. Our sample size is 41, our sample mean 5.7. If we had the raw data, we could click here and input the range. We don't need the title, and we're not going to be concerned with the finite population correction, but there are questions in my stat lab that have to do with that. PHStat will solve that for you. So we just click OK. And can't really tell because it just duplicated again. It brought up our answer, the 5.46 and the 5.94, which is what Ernesto got. It gives you the critical value of Z of minus 1.96. And from the standard error, which is nothing more than the population standard deviation divided by the square root of 41, that's at 0.1249. You multiply those and you get the interval half width, and then you add and subtract that to the sample mean to get these. So the PHStat is a pretty quick way of doing that, and it's got a lot of neat statistical tools. There's our descriptives, and it gives us all kind of plots, our histogram, which you'll see a lot of, stem and leaf, scatter plots, and the box plot, which is very, very useful, and a dot plot is too. If we're doing decision making, which you use in Business 430, you've got a number of things that are useful. Population distributions, we have a lot of questions about that in Business 233. And there are the various distributions that we use. Sampling, we can generate random sampling. Confidence intervals, we've gone over. Sample size, That's a question on a lot of the quizzes. And then our hypothesis tests. One sample test, both the Z, T, chi-square, and Z test were proportion. Two sample for our raw data, and that gives our pool variance, and we'll talk about that. Two sample, multi-sample, which is the ANOVAs that we generally do in the chi-square, and regression, simple, multiple, and some more advanced versions of that. So PHStat, I would encourage you to look at. I wish I had mentioned it at the first part of the class for $10. It's a very useful tool. It builds right into Excel, and what it's doing, if you look at these equations, or these areas, blue is input, yellow is the final output, white is the intermediates. You can see it's using the Excel formulas to calculate these values. Same thing for the Z value and the standard error. And once you develop these spreadsheets, if you relabel them, you can just go back and put in new data. I'm going to put in one, and everything recalculates, so you can reuse that. It's a quick way to build a workbook that has a lot of built-in templates for you. And I have no stock in PHStat.